Let me start by saying that, again, this is not coaches' rhetoric. When you look at the stride that was made, you look at the total yards, 567 to roughly, what, 380. You see the direction that we're headed in. We can run the ball. We can be physical and we can play as a team. And it's not lip service. As you get to know me over this period of time, you'll understand that I never sugarcoat and I tell the truth. I don't embellish anything. This team is getting better and it will continue to do that. Whether I'm in this position or not, those boys have come together tight and they're determined. So without that being said, I think and I felt that they fought hard. I felt that they showed a different side of Beaver football than I've seen since I've been here. And I couldn't be more happier for them. I mean, just to see the right kind of emotion after a game like that. Times are changing.
Questions?
Corey, right after the game on the field, you took a moment, you said, wow, we should have got the W, but that was a great start. What was going through your mind? What were the emotions you were feeling and why was it the start you wanted?
Well, the thing that we talked about as a staff is establishing the run and kind of getting back to the basics and kind of who we were and how we left off at the end of last season. And if you watch that game, the way the offense performed and ran the ball, I mean, it's who we are. It's our identity. So people have been asking, and I've been able to say that we were establishing it. So I said, wow, you know, we should have, because if you look at the numbers, right, you look at the stats, the score is no indicator of what really happened. Now, hats off to their offense. You know, they made plays when they had to. They made their plays. And on defense, we didn't make enough plays. But let the record reflect. When you look at both columns, total yardage, we won. So that's why I said, wow, we should have won that by the numbers, because numbers never lie, right?
Corey, you talked about the right kind of emotion after a game. How would you contrast what you saw today to what you've seen after previous losses, and how did you address the team after a tough one?
Today, like I said, it was more of a disappointment, because today was like if we were 6-0 and this was our first loss. So it was that kind of emotion. If I can, you know, paint a different picture. All right, those boys were determined and was just like, you know what, coming to work, and this is who we are. This is what we've established. And instead of it being like more of a here we go again, or like, man, like the season, what else is gonna happen? It was different. You know, their demeanor was like they can't wait, you know, to play football next Saturday. You know, I know we have the bye, but you know, to describe what I meant by that, their emotion, it was a healthy emotion.
Can you talk about the jump in the run game this week, and especially Ryan's play?
I mean, again, it's who we are. You know, it's what this staff and this recruiting department has built. And so I think what we tried to focus on was just boiling it down to, you know, one dynamic, you know, and one identity, instead of saying, you know, we're just gonna do what the situation calls for. We're gonna do what works. We're gonna go ahead and do what we're good at. And so that's why I say, you know, and the players know, that's why you say there's nothing to hang your head down at, because, I mean, we start the season off like this, and now what? You know, what are we talking about? Like I said, for those boys, this is a fresh start. And, you know, Ryan Nall, he came in, and you got to figure, too, he's probably around, what, 90-95% healthy. I would say that has a lot to do with it. But, again, the biggest thing is they've come together, and I'm going to tell you that. I mean, O-linemen, you know, wide receivers, tight ends, the quarterback, everybody has come together, and they understand the goal. You know, I brought them up, we talked about it, we said we're going to establish our identity, and that's what we're doing, and that's what you saw.
Yeah. You said that you showed a different side of yourself, your team did. What led to that? How were you able to do that?
Because, like I said, I think you, when you're honest with people, right, I think a good coach, a great coach, not only tells you what you want to hear, but tells you what you need to hear. And we've had a lot of real conversations, and there's a lot of real buy-in. And the reason why there's a lot of real buy-in is because, obviously, when you experience success with blind faith, right? Someone tells you something and you have to kind of just believe what they say is what it is. Well, those practices, right, the energy, and saying that the energy that myself and the rest of the coaching staff and, you know, what we bring is real, and caring for this team is real, and it's not just a, you know, we're going to roll over and play dead. We really are here for you. Well, I think that puts the athlete, the student athlete, in the frame of mind that we really are family. We really do care for one another. I mean, you saw a staff get a lot closer, and then you saw players get a lot closer. You saw confidence in the offensive play calling, offensive scheme. So when you show the athlete that, the student athlete, that you care, right, when you show them that, and they actually experience the success, and because you've been open, honest, and truthful with them, that's been the difference.
Corey, considering everything that's gone on over the past week, and then 5 minutes ago, you guys have a lead, what's going through your mind? What are you telling the players?
We're gonna finish like we started. Nothing changes. I was reminding them. My thing is, I said, goal versus result, right? The result is not what we concern ourselves. We concern ourselves with our goal. And if we accomplish our goal, the result will take care of itself. And so that's what I said throughout the whole game. But then I gave them a goal this morning. And every time I said, remember the goal, it was 4 quarters long. What is our goal? Don't focus and don't worry about the result. Because as long as we accomplish the goal, the result will happen. And so going into it 5 minutes into it, I mean, you look at it there. You talk about right there in the situation on the third down, you know, they send an all-out zero blitz. We try to run to go ahead and center it up to kick the field goal. And they knock us five yards back out of our kicker's field goal range. Again, that's football, right? Things happen like that because we could be having a different conversation right now. We could be going into overtime and getting ready to play a new set of downs. So I just wanted to keep them focused on that because they watched that offense. Every time they had the ball, except for being stalled maybe once, right? They watched that offense move the ball. So now you had kids, you had players, you had student athletes and young men that believed. So it didn't matter. If we would have got that field goal, they believed just as long as we have another opportunity, right, to accomplish a goal, the result will take care of itself. And they saw how close they came to accomplishing that goal fully, and they see the result that was going to be the outcome.
So what was the goal?
You want to know, Drew? The goal was just to inflict pain. That's it, right? You know, I mean, football, that's why you say run the ball. You got to soften players up, okay? I mean, it's football. Football hurts people, you know? And so what we want to do is we want to be aggressive and physical. And that's our goal. Down in and down out, offensively and defensively. And that's what we're going to work on, and that's what we're going to get better at, right? Because, like I said, I believe pain has memory. Pain is a part of the sport. But as long as we're giving more than we're taking, then we'll accomplish our goal and we'll come out of there victorious. So that lineman, those old line were in there and they had a mission. Those D linemen, that front seven, they were in there, they had a mission. Everyone across the board had a mission. And it was just to keep them focused, not just on scoreboards, not just on statistics, but on that goal to where at the end of it, they can go ahead and experience success, a successful result.
You talked about the run game, which was effective, but also the passing game. I would say Darryl you think he had his best game and talk about him?
Well, again, I mean, that's why you run the football. You run the football to protect the quarterback. And we've seen Darryl Grierson do this before, okay? So for me, it doesn't come as a surprise. It doesn't come as a shock at all. He's a good athlete, and I think he displayed that, and he's surrounded by good athletes. So now, you know, we have some time to get back to a lot of basics, to become competitive in practice a lot more, and establish that, continue to establish our brand and our identity. And Darryl Gerritsen is going to be the guy who's leading that. And I mean, I couldn't be more happy for him today, because what that built in him is confidence. Confidence in his teammates, confidence from his coaches. Then now he's confident in his teammates, and now he's confident in his coaches.
Okay, last question. I'll get these players in here, Danny.
Well, we saw a lot of offensive creativity, multiple back sets, substitutions. Did you have an imprint on that as far as what the offensive coaches were doing, and why was it so different this week than in prior weeks?
I've said it before, and I'll stand behind it now. We have professional coaches here. I mean, these guys have been in this profession for a long time. So for me to sit here and take pats on the back and say that I've had anything to do with it, I give it to those coordinators, okay, on both sides of the ball. Just ask them to give me their best, give these players their best, give everybody a chance to be successful, and this is the direction, and this is what we've started, and this is the direction that we'll head from here on out. So those coordinators, just they took the game plan, they did what the players felt comfortable with, and that's what you saw today. So my hats off to that offensive staff for putting together a great game plan.
Thank you, Coach.